going on? This is Clutter Manufacturing here, man. We're ready to kick it off with another freaking teach your mother freaking ass how to do Mastercam and how to improve yourself in the manufacturing freaking world. So don't give me a bunch of crap on how I sound or what the hell's going on. Without further ado, today what we are going to learn is thread milling and cut tabs. So you're going to learn the how to thread mill and how to use a freaking cut tab. And we're going to go through it step by step. Hopefully you can follow along here. So I hope you like this tutorial. Let's get rocking, bro. So let's go right into business. So what you're going to do is someone's going to say, hey, man, we need a 1/4-20, Craig, and we need it 1 inch away from XYZ zero. We need it negative 1 inch in the Y and positive 1 inch in the X. So what you're going to do, you're going to go into your view, and you're going to hit show axes. Okay, and I like to switch it up like that. And then in the view here, we're going to put our fucking... We're going to put our point right here. Put a point right there. There we go. I put a point right there. Okay, green check. All right, now what we want to do, now we know that point is right on the center axis of all that stuff. So what I want to do is I'm going to come in here, man, and I'm going to turn this off. So we have nothing but the frickin' point to make it clear as frickin' day. Because I want this to be easy for you guys, man. You know, I don't want you guys to be struggling. So here's your point. So they said... I said, hey, man, in the field, they said, hey, man, the XY zero is right fucking here. And what did I say it was? We're going to grab this point, and we're going to go transform, translate. And they said it was positive 1 inch in the X, negative 1 inch in the Y, okay? We're going to back out so we can see where we're moving it. All right, so now we're going to copy it so we can see where our XY zero is right here, and then where our point is right here. So now what we want to do is we want to put our 1/4-20, which they said that they need, on the floor. That's what they're going to do out there in the field, man. And they're going to put pressure on you and fuck with you. So what we're going to do, because I'm a strong believer in backplot verification. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with our minor diameter. So whatever, this will work with any thread, by the way. So the minor diameter of the 1/4-20 is going to be 201, all right? We're going to lock that bitch up to 201, bam. So we're going to hit 201. And you can see there is our home, and we're going to put our 201 right there. So what we're going to do with our 201 is our minor diameter. So your minor diameter, that's going to be your drill depth. How deep do you want your drill to go? So what I did is I selected my circle. I'm going to select my circle. Go to transform, translate. And I want my drill to go 700 thou. So I went in my Z right here. I type negative 700 thou and I want to join. And when you join it, it gives that line and it connects it. You see what I'm saying, bro? So now after all this stuff, I like to right click clear colors so all the colors are the same. So now you have your minor diameter developed. Now for verification purposes, I want to put a larger circle over this. Unlock this. Right here, I unlock this frame. And I'm just going to put a larger circle around that. It doesn't matter the diameter, you know, and I'm going to green check that. So now what I'm going to do here, now I know I'm where I need to be at off my XYZ zero plane. So I'm going to delete that point, which was my XYZ zero. You know what I'm saying? So let's get this going. You know what I mean? Let's go into surfaces and we're going to hit loft. And we're going to grab these two and make sure they're going in the same direction. See, that one was freaking counterclockwise. That one is counterclockwise. Okay, we want to do the same here. Make sure green, our blue check to accept. Now we want to go to flat surface. And you need to do this stuff when you're doing this. Because for verification purposes, you need to have it modeled out. You know. So we're going to green check that. Now what you want to do is you're going to want to drop this down. You're going to go to stock setup, select all entities, and it's selected everything we just made. Turn your display off, uncheck that, green check, okay? Now what we want to do is we want to, I like to get the spot and the chamfer and everything done all at once. So we're going to go right into tool paths, we're going to go to drill. All right, you guys follow me there? So we're going to select that center point, just the point. So I'm going to hit P for point, so it goes to point. and select that point. I'm going to hit green check. I'm going to go to my tool, select tool library. I'm going to go to my filter. I want none. And then I'm going to go right here to my spot drill. And make your spot drill bigger than the largest major diameter of your thread. So I'm going to go to 3/8. So now I'm going to double click that. I'm going to call that tool number one. And we're going to say that we're going to be making this in aluminum. So in aluminum, I like to go to 225, 10, 10, 10. And then I round this off to 2300. So there you go. Then we're going to put in here spot. Bam. Okay. Now everybody knows what it is. It's going to be a drill counter bar. So the depth, we're going to go to this calculator. Make sure everything's absolute, absolute, and clearance of 1 inch. And absolute. Okay. Now after that, go to your deal here. Now it's going to be a 250,000. Outside diameter, so we want to make that 265. That'll give it roughly 7 thou edge break on that deal. So it looks like we started awfully high on that. It's the retract we want to put to 100 thou. I didn't catch that. I'm gonna regenerate that, so that's what we're gonna get. So now we want to watch this go through. If you want to. Make sure you're going to cut some meat. You saw some meat get cut. Now we're going to right click, drag this down, let go, copy after. Now we're going to go into our minor diameter. So we're going to go into our tool, select library, filter, unselect that, go to your drill. Now we need a 201 drill. Okay, go to your 201 drill, double click that. Double click it in your box, the 201 number 7 drill. Okay, now we're going to call that number 2. Okay, same thing, 225. Okay, 10, 10, 10, 4300. Okay, I rounded that off, that's all I did. So now we're going to drill the minor, drill minor. Go to your drill counter bar. Let's change that to peck drill. We want to do a peck drill to break the chip. Let's put the peck in at 100 thou. Okay, I like it. Sure, that works for me. The depth, how deep do we want to go? Well, we want to go to the bottom of this. Okay, that's 700 thou. But now that's not going to be totally 700 thou. We want to add the depth of the drill. So finish diameter, put the diameter of your drill. And make sure it says add to depth, and it'll automatically add that to your depth. Okay, and I like to just make that rounded like that. So now there's your minor. Okay, let's watch that go through. Here's your tool two minor, bam bam, does the peck and all that stuff. Great. So now what we want to do is we're going to come into tool path. We're going to drop this arrow down. We're going to go into thread mill, and we're going to select the point. So we want to hit P for point, grab that point, make sure it says point, green check. Threadmill, now this is going to get a little tricky. So now you need to know geometry of the tool. It's that simple. Just look up the tool in the manufacturing catalog. So what you want to do is you want to create tool. And in this, I'm going to create a threadmill. Okay, I double click that. So your threads per inch, you want to put that on there. Your outside diameter, which I like that. So this is a 2-inch end mill. So this is a single point end mill, so I only want to put one thread pitch in there. Okay, the outside diameter, sorry, is 1875 of the thread mill. Shoulder length is 0.500 thou. Actually, it's 550. And now the shoulder diameter is 100 thou. Okay? So now what we got here is the taper angle, which is usually 15 to 20 degrees. Okay, this particular tool is 15. Okay, so there's my thread mill. Bam, I just made my thread mill. So now go to finalize properties. Call that your next runner-up of a tool. Give this, okay, I'm going to give it my end mill properties, 1875. So we're going to run this in aluminum. We're going to run it at 10 grand, and I'm going to say 10 inches a minute. Now you just made your threadmill. Let's call that your quarter inch, your quarter 20 threadmill. Okay, finish. Now we're going to come into your parameters. Make sure your pitch is right. Make sure your wear is on. It's going to be on computer. Turn that to wear. That'll turn your D value on. Type in your major diameter. That's going to be at 1 inch. You want to turn that to 250 thou. Okay, make sure everything's as you see it here. Your lead in, lead out. 5 thou right here. That's pretty much all you're going to change. If you want to give a multi-passes, go ahead and turn that on. Skip that. These two here. Go to Lincoln parameters. And let's go as deep as you want it to. You know, save these parameters right here to do this tutorial. And then, of course, turn your coolant on. So now green check. Oh, that somehow went on top of that. So we want that to be underneath everything here. So now I'm going to zoom in here. Okay, so let's see what happens here when we do the verify. I selected all my tool paths by selecting tool group 1. And then I selected my verify. Something's they don't like about the tool. It's probably because I didn't import it. It's not a big deal. Don't worry about it. So let's turn this performance all the way up, and let's see what we get. And I just hit turbo there. I'm hitting too many buttons at once for my slow-ass computer. Okay, now I'm going to hit the green button to compare because the minor diameter should be green. You can see the thread in there. Let's turn that cutter off. But you see, you can see a perfect thread in there. All right, so there you have it. So you can see the green is the minor diameter. The blue is the thread. I think I made a perfect thread. So let's go ahead and back on out of here. So that's how you make a thread in Mastercam. Now to do a cut tap, you're going to simply grab this, copy after your pectoral, okay? Go into your parameters, go to your tool, select tool from library, go to your filter. Now you're going to go to your right-hand tap, green check. You're going to go to your quarter 20 right here, quarter 20 tap. Call that tap 4, number tool number 4. Now what you're going to do is you want to go that 20 inches a minute and 400 RPM, okay? So we're going to come into here. We're going to turn this pec drill to tap. And we don't want to go that deep. We only want to go 500 thou. All right, so that's how you do your cut tap. All right. Well, I hit save. Sorry about that. Regenerate. So thanks again. Clotter Manufacturing coming straight at you. Take it easy.